We have Chef Peter Beck here from Banaras Grill.
Yeah, we have like tandoori grilled shrimp, which is known as anguri jinga. It goes with the grape relish. Instead of giving tamarind, we have made a chutney with the grapes. So that is, and it's like shrimp marinated in ginger, garlic, ajwain, and then cooked in tandoor.
Oh, wow, we have Rahul Walia here, the founder of the South Asian Spelling Bee.
All the decadence, let's see.
And a live reaction.
It's very delectable.
Now, what do we have here?
Our shrimps, they're cooked in white wine, and they are cooked with peppercorns.
I'm a hardcore vegetarian, I'm also a health freak. So we're gonna get a sample, I'm gonna give some to the my camera guy, Ben. All right, Ben, what'd you think? According to Ben, super delicious.
This is a momo. It comes from a momo family, but instead of the white flour, we had made this momo in a lettuce leaf.
Now I can be healthy, watch my waistline, and still not compromise on taste.
So we hear that you're the next big guy in kebabs and curries, you know, in India. Most vegetarian kebabs I've had, very dry, not really fun to eat with.
Well, to be very honest, for any chef, it's a real challenge when it comes to vegetarians. What I've tried to do is, you know, do a very simple innovation with the kebabs. Like I do a kebab called a galotti kebab. It's a non-veg. I do a vegetarian version with mushrooms. The only thing is that I flavor it with truffle oil. So it's like a truffle galotti. So, you know, it's a vegetarian kebab, but it's exciting.
Now, in 2010, I believe, you launched your recent restaurant, Metapur. What was the thought process in figuring out the menu?
I think I keep it very true to who I am and the style I do. I've been a pastry chef mainly, so it has those pastry components to it. Taking influences of what I have learned in terms of spices, herbs, mixing them, really encompassing what I love.
So I figured that I should try out some dessert and some sweets. So what do we have here?
Today we have red velvet with Nutella and milk chocolate mousse. It's actually a number one seller. We have Malai Kulfi cupcakes. And then down here we have chocolate Guinness cake, Bailey's Irish mousse, and whiskey ganache.
So I definitely want to try something out. What should I try first?
Red velvet, hands down.
It's really delicious. I can taste the red velvet. Definitely taste the Nutella.
So we focus a lot on not adding a lot of sugar.
Do you know how many calories it is? For the calorie conscious.
We don't count calories. We think that you should enjoy life, enjoy chocolate, enjoy Nutella, and enjoy pastries.
Yeah, she's teaching me a lesson or two.
All my sweets are Indian Middle Eastern inspired sweets, and a lot of them are nut and fruit based sweets. We had walnut apple spice, coconut chocolate ganache, and we were also featuring our latest addition, which were our new truffles. We had medjool date with pistachio, and our latest, which is apple cranberry with roasted almonds.
It truly is sweet and a little bit silky. We have Chef Vikas Khanna, probably the hardest chef to find here. You're an amazing chef. You're a food writer, filmmaker, humanitarian, a TV host of MasterChef India. You know, they call you an entrepreneur with a vision. What's next in line? It seems like you accomplished everything.
Oh, you know, you don't decide next step. I'm a total believer of something called cosmic schedule. That there's a universe there. And what you wish for, what you aspire for, the universe creates a schedule for you. It keeps you very grounded. It keeps your projects very organic.
So you've been recognized by the James Beard Foundation. What emotions you were going through when you found out you were recognized by such a prestigious foundation?
When you go to such a prestigious institution, you're not representing yourself or your restaurant or your cuisine or your talent. You're representing your motherland. And you have to be very right, correct, and to your best, because you're representing the country, which gives you everything.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure. I enjoyed a lot interviewing you.
Sat Sri Akaal, everyone.
We are doing a very, very simple dish. I'm going to heat some oil. You swirl the pan, so you use minimum amount of oil. I'm going to add some mustard seeds to it. Add some curry leaves. This is what we call tadka, which is called infusion of oil with all these flavors. That's what's happening right now. So to this, I'm gonna add 1/4 cup of peanut, which have been coarsely ground, just like this. So here we have, the peanut is slowly burning. And to this, I'm gonna add 1 whole can of coconut milk. To this, little salt, and then 4 baby eggplants like this. I have slit them and fried them. I'm gonna just put them inside the simmering sauce. We let the sauce simmer. One very interesting ingredient I'm adding to this is, I'm gonna add 2 tablespoons of pomegranate molasses to it. It adds a very, very nice sour taste. We let this simmer so the coconut and eggplant really infuse all the flavors together. The dish is pomegranate coconut flavored eggplants. Thank you very much. Have a great evening.
So we're here with Master Chef Sanjeev Kapoor, Master Chef, TV host, author of best-selling books, restaurateur, architect of many food products, winner of many culinary awards. Like, what do you not do? It's like Superman here.
I feel that you have one life. If you can do path-breaking things, then you get some sense of achievement. I believe that my role is to make sure that I give Indian food its importance that it should have. And my belief is that very soon it can become number one food in the world.
I'm going to give you a little challenge. So I'm vegetarian, and I'm also a little bit of a health freak, so I try to avoid paneer. On top of your mind, what's the best thing you can do with tofu for someone like me?
I puree it, and any gravy that you're making, add that, it gives nice creamy texture to your gravy. There's no cream in it, and yet, when you taste it, it says, wow. So you know it's healthy, it's nice and creamy, mouthfeel is really good. So you can try it with anything, maybe just a simple aloo matar with gravy, and so add some pureed silken tofu, and there you go.
My mouth's already watering. I definitely have to get this recipe after this interview.
I'm here in the air for you guys. Namak Shamak, Namak Shamak, Dal Dete Hai. Namak Shamak, Namak Shamak, Dal Dete Hai. So, let's begin the demo, chef.
Okay, just prawns marinated with salt, lime and a little bit of red chilies. Marinated for about 5 to 15 minutes. Put ghol ghol dete hain slightly. So what we are going to do is soak this paper. It's actually rice paper. Spinach leaves, baby spinach leaves, some paper, some prawns, some sprouted beans. 8 minute, yaar. Aur paan hai, namak hai, nahi paan denge. Namak waaste pura drama karna padta hai. Now I'm going to invite Ricky and Varli on stage. So they have 3 prizes, right? And this has been, these are 3 restaurants. We have most unique restaurant. The prize goes to Banaras.
Banaras.
Most unique. Very good, congratulations. Keep it up. Okay, now the second prize is for best taste. Chand Palace. Chand Palace. Lovely.
Chand Palace, great.
Kya baat hai. Okay, congratulations, very good. We have now best presentation by a restaurant tonight at Varli Food Festival, and the prize goes to Mint. Mint. Congratulations. Fantastic. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.